Hey, Ronald.
Hey, Luke. Lewis.
When we were growing up, you know, all caution was thrown to the wind when it came to toys that we played with.
Pretty much.
And the way we played with them, too. You should see some of the things I used to do on my bike. When I had to get a new bike, it was because the frame was completely broken.
Yeah.
But toys that we had as kids would never fly today.
Oh, no.
They would never pass the test and be put on the market.
No.
But some of the toys we played with, we're going to share with you, and I don't mean share and play. I mean, we're going to
that would be fun
talk about in the next Men Are So Smart.
Stand I challenge by. You to lawn darts.
Kids today probably think they have the coolest toys. The dramatic technological advances that occurred when many of us were already adults have no doubt afforded them some really cool things. But their toys have nothing on the ones from our decades. Most kids today might scoff at the idea of spending an afternoon wearing moon shoes or slinging sky dancers, but simply, they don't know what they've missed out on.
Yep. In fact, views on parenting have also changed a lot in the past few decades. There were plenty of toys that our moms and dads didn't think twice about getting us that would elicit some pretty outraged Facebook rants today.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, everything elicits Facebook rants today. somehow, we survived the era of inappropriate and dangerous toys, and we made it out with character. Thank you very much.
Yeah!
Yeah, so let's hit some of these top dangerous toys that we played with.
All right, well, you heard me refer to moon shoes. Now, I don't think either one of us had these.
I did not.
But here's a picture. Moon shoes might seem like an unlikely toy from the get-go, seeing as you generally don't want kids to fall from greater heights than they already do. They seem downright crazy when you realize that from the 1950s through the 70s, they were made of metal. Metal springs. A metal base, and you're jumping on this stuff.
Yeah,
you talk about dangerous.
Oh yeah, yeah. Not looks like fun.
Sure.
Yeah, it's like a pogo stick on both feet.
Would we have done it?
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. If I'd had a set, I would.
I'd have hopped all the way to your house.
I'd still be doing it. Yeah. Okay, this next one.
All right.
Slightly inappropriate by today's standards. Happy Family Midge and Baby.
Oh, I sure don't remember this.
Yeah, me neither. I didn't play with Barbies much.
Well, not much.
Not a lot.
Just admitted.
A little. A midge. A smidge.
A smidge.
I played a smidge with Midge. Barbie's best bud.
That explains a lot, really. Listen.
Barbie's best bud welcomed a baby, which wouldn't be weird under normal conditions. The strange way the baby came out is what gives pause.
This I gotta hear.
The doll came with a magnetic bump that concealed a small baby doll, so girls just popped off the bump and reached in for the baby. Yeah, because that's how babies are delivered.
Oh, Barbie's gynecologist.
It's a weird detail that probably wouldn't be considered politically correct today.
Yeah, you probably think? Not. Can you imagine the commercials on TV?
Oh, God. No.
All right. Creepy crawlers, Ronnie. We had these.
I had this.
And when you think, listen, this is so dangerous. Creepy crawlers originally debuted in the 1960s, the mid-1960s, but were recalled after it was discovered that children and heating elements and metal don't mix.
What?
Who would have thought? Who would have thought?
How could they not see that?
An improved upon version was then released in the 1990s, but still held just as many safety concerns as Easy Bake ovens did. You're giving kids heating elements. They're going to burn themselves.
Okay, now right along, this is not on the list, but this should be. Wood burning set. Did you ever have one?
Is that scrolling pin?
It's a soldering iron.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a flat soldering iron.
I remember that.
That you would draw on a piece of wood that was made to burn rather easily.
Yeah, like balsa wood.
Yes, but holy cow, I think, I don't know how many houses burnt down because of you know, this soldering iron that was unattended by children.
Yeah, Christmas night, probably.
Yeah.
How many fires started because of that toy.
So, right up there with Creepy Crawlers is the wood-burning set. And I totally get that.
Next up is Sky Dancers. They were a prettier way of outfitting young children with high-powered slingshots.
It's true.
First thing I think of is Dennis the Menace. Always had that one in his back pocket. Huh? Despite causing all sorts of injuries ranging from chipped teeth to concussions, they have Sky Dancer protocol. That began when the toys were released in 1994. These toys weren't even recalled until 6 years later in 2000.
Oh, wow.
What's a few kids here and there?
Yeah.
It's the cost of doing business.
Yeah, you grew up tough or you don't grow up at all.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, this next one.
All right.
A little disturbing. It's the Cabbage Patch Snack Time Kid.
I remember Cabbage Patch.
Cabbage Patch, in fact, I still have two or three up in one of our closets. Unopened.
You're a hoarder.
Christine in the box.
You are a hoarder. I know you are.
It's my wife.
Oh, okay.
It's all my wife.
All right.
But the Cabbage Patch Snack Time Kid was one of the most sought-after toys when it was first released in time for Christmas 96.
Yeah, I remember.
So my kids would have been about 8 years old or about 10 years old, I guess, at the time. The hype over the product turned to outrage after parents discovered the doll's ability to chew was actually pretty dangerous. The toy would chew anything you put near its mouth, eating the hair of many little girls.
Oh, I bet.
I bet.
And, I don't even want to think about what that could be used for. Okay, on our list of vintage toys parents would never let their kids play with or anywhere near them today, soccer boppers. Do you remember these?
You know what? A friend around the corner had some. Ed.
Uh-huh.
My friend Ed had some.
Which explains a lot, Ronnie.
And we used the hell out of them.
Which explains a lot, Ronnie. Soccer boppers. Well, many parents today wouldn't dare encourage their kids to hit anyone. In the 90s, though, these inflatable glove-like devices were given to us with adult blessings to beat the crap out of each other.
Yeah.
It wouldn't have been relatively harmless if the sharp plastic seams didn't cut the skin so easily. They're probably sharp as knives.
You know, they were that kind of plastic that's a little bit brittle and hard.
Yeah, kind of like those air mattresses.
Yes. And so if you remember the old vinyl plastic, they had seams on them. And those seams would cut you.
They were. Oh, sure. It's like when you... Oh, yeah. I remember. Yep.
All right. Next one. And this was more of a girl toy, but
I remember that.
I remember girls in the neighborhood had them. It's called the Skip It.
Yeah.
And it's the one where you put it on one foot, and then you twirl it around, and you hop over it.
Right, right.
Well, it's a little bit too intimidating for some of the klutzier kids. The braver ones endured many a heinous bruise as a result of the heavy, unwieldy toy. Not only that, but if you didn't skip it just right, you might actually land on the ball part of it and then
break your ankle.
Yeah, you got some twisted ankles for sure.
Next up, I'll tell you, let me set the scene on this one, Ronnie, okay? You had a big backyard in your mom's house.
We had a big backyard, yeah.
And let's just say you had a nice old hill back there.
Oh.
What you do is you lay out this like piece of plastic or vinyl, and it was about 50 feet long, and you would wet that thing, and then you'd take off running, and about 5 feet in front of it, you would dive on it.
Right.
Slip and slides. Did you have one as a kid?
Yes.
Do your kids have them now?
No.
Well, from the 70s, well into the 90s, slip and slide was a staple in backyards across the country. Slipping sounds fun until the landing doesn't stick.
Yeah.
And a number of people learned that lesson the hard way. Although they're still around today, they've been updated to be much safer.
Yeah. Well,
Thank goodness.
The problem was there was nothing at the end.
Right.
To keep you from going off and getting a kind of a little bit of a grass burn
at about 55 miles an hour.
Yeah. So, and ours had basically little soaker hoses along both sides to constantly keep it wet.
Oh yeah, that's the most important part.
And you could really rip on that thing. And I don't know how many times I had the wind knocked out of me by doing a belly first slide.
Oh.
So, that was a toy that I loved to hate.
Oh, this next one, I remember these so well, the smell.
Yeah, the...
Oh, whoops.
I think you went ahead of me.
I'm sorry.
Yep. So this next one was the slap bracelets.
Oh, I think I know what that was.
Again, this was more of a girl thing.
Uh-huh.
They were like a thin piece of metal, you know, probably about this big.
Uh-huh.
And when you hit them to your wrist, they wrap around your wrist.
Mm-hmm.
They were, you know, made of plastic, but they were plastic covered metal.
Okay.
And it was a cool 80s accessory. The slap wraps were more dangerous than they appeared. The fabric that covered the piece of metal to make the bracelet, well, that eventually wore out, leaving you with just a razor sharp piece of metal. Yeah.
Sounds safe to me.
They're also very popular in prison.
Yeah.
So
I'm sure.
Yeah.
You know, off topic just a second. I can remember a time when my mom would go, okay, here's your toy. Now go outside and don't come home until 5 o'clock.
Yep.
Yeah. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning. I could wear one of them slap bracelets out by the time I was done. Next up, Bloonies. Ronnie, this was that goop.
Oh.
That you'd put on the end of like a really thick ass straw.
I do remember that.
And then you'd blow that sucker up into a ball. And then you could like tie it off, almost balloon-like, using tiny straws and mystery goop. Bloonies helped you create colorful, sticky bubbles that looked like so much fun. Unfortunately, they smelled like nothing but chemicals.
It did.
That's what it was.
It's like smelling the mimeograph machine.
Even worse.
Yeah.
It wasn't long before parents began questioning whether breathing in this stuff could be good for children. Well, it wasn't. I assure you it wasn't.
Now this next one, I think it was, I want to say it would be a little bit after we were kids,
mm-hmm.
The roller racer. And basically it's a plastic seat with handlebars.
Uh-huh.
And, it was responsible for more than a few fingers getting run over.
Ooh.
Yeah. It really kept you really very low to the ground. Uh-huh. You're also invisible to cars. Another recipe for disaster, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not PC for today.
Yeah, I don't remember too much about those. Next up, growing up skipper. I know you're saying, well, what could be so bad about that?
Yeah.
Well, just a twirl of her arm transforms Skipper into a teenager by simply giving her breasts.
What?
You twist the arm and her breasts grow. I knew a girl like that once in Tijuana. The message is all kinds of crazy and not what empowered women of today want their daughters striving for. I wonder if some boys played with that doll. I bet you.
Oh, yeah. No, this next one, this is the coup de grace.
This is the capper right here. We'll end with this one.
Yep. Lawn darts.
Oh, come on.
You had basically... sharpened. They're like darts that you throw, except they're 50 times bigger.
Right. They're much thicker than a dart.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you could, the idea was they had two little plastic hoops.
Right.
And you would stand, one person would stand by this set, and the other person would stand by that plastic hoop, and you would throw them to try to get them in the plastic hoop.
Kind of like... What's that called?
A cornhole.
Cornhole game.
Very much like
but
a cornhole
game. But with sharp objects.
But with sharp flying objects.
And they could go through your eyes, your hand, your foot.
Well, eventually, it gets boring just tossing them like this. So you toss them
as high
in the air as you can.
Yeah, I remember.
To get them to come down.
Yeah.
And if the sun's in your eye or you lose sight of one, you could lose an eye.
Recipe for disaster.
You could literally lose an eye. Yeah,
lawn darts, boy. And you had one other one, Ron. You were telling me about the balls.
Oh yeah,
right.
The clackers.
Oh yeah, that's what they are.
The clackers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't know. So what these were? They were two
marble-like things.
They were like marbles, but they were plastic.
Mm-hmm.
But they were heavy plastic balls, secured with a string,
uh-huh.
and they had a ring for your finger in the
middle.
I'll
give you some room so you can do it.
Yes, and so you do this.
Careful, I don't know what you're doing there.
You do this, and the balls come up, and they hit each other, and
right,
they go down.
Right.
And the idea was to get them going so fast that it's almost like a perpetual motion machine.
Uh-huh.
You just do this, 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 this.
Yes.
Clack, clack, clack. Well, notice the proximity to my face. that these are. I'm
noticing the proximity to your nether regions.
Yes, which is also not a good. That's also a recipe for disaster. But I don't know how many times I got hit in the face with those hard balls.
Yeah.
Wow. To have all my teeth is still a testament that.
You know what we were? We were the forefathers for you kids of today. That's what we were.
Yeah.
We were like the guinea pigs. just sell it to them. They'll love it. No matter if it smells like chemicals, what could go wrong?
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah. We wonder why the cancer rates are up so high. Actually, I was reading a story about that, and I'm not so sure that's true. But in any case, hope you enjoyed today's show on dangerous toys that we grew up on that would never pass the test. Nowadays,
no.
We'd love your comments if there were some that we may have left out. We didn't have time to get to all of them.
Or if you had a way more dangerous toilet, let us hear about it.
Oh, I'm sure there was bunches of them. We mentioned that easy bake oven.
Yeah.
That's a great idea. Great idea. What if that gets left on overnight?
Did you ever have one of the cakes that came out of there?
Yeah, they weren't very good.
Pretty awful.
Awful.
My cousin Shirley made some.
Shirley, you jest. All right. Thanks much for watching. Please subscribe to our channel and click the bell, too, so that you get notifications each time a show comes out. I'm Lou Gallagher.
I'm Corvette Ronnie.
We will see you on the next Men Are So Smart.